Ah, people, in this evening's video, I'm going to get that electricity meter there, which is up in front of the camera. And what I'm going to do is, a little later on in another video, so I'm going to get that electricity meter and I am going to phantom load it. And yes, we're going to get that electricity meter whizzed right up at a nice speed. And yeah, this is going to be the first phantom load electricity meter on my channel. Okay. Now, what is phantom loading? Okay, you're probably asking yourself that. You know, what is phantom loading? Well, the way I would word it is basically it's a load on one of those up in front of the camera there, a kilowatt hour electricity meter, and basically the load doesn't actually exist, hence it being called a phantom load. Yeah, it doesn't. The load doesn't actually exist, but it makes the electricity meter whack around at a silly speed. Okay, of the user's choice, of course, within the rating on that electricity meter. And yes, you know, with a variac, you've got to have a variac in order to do it, because you need some kind of control to get that electricity meter whizzing around at a speed of your choice and within the specifications of the electricity meter or the energy source, okay, whichever comes first. You know, I mean, if you've got, say for example, an 80 amp electric meter, but you've only got a 10 amp source, you won't want to put 40 amps through that electric meter because you'll burn out your 10 amp source. Okay. So, well, in this video, I'm going to pull the camera back now at 2 minutes 30 seconds and we'll have a look at a few of the bits which are needed to get that electricity meter phantom loaded. Okay. So, hold on there a moment. Just forgot one little thing. I'm just going to place it down there. Okay, right, here we go. Right, let's pull the camera back at 3 minutes. So, the obvious thing that you're going to need in order to phantom load is a kilowatt hour electricity meter, like that one up in front of the camera there. It doesn't have to be dual tariff, it can be single tariff, as long as it's a kilowatt hour electricity meter. You can even do it with electronic meters, okay? It doesn't have to be a meter with a load wheel in it. As long as it measures kilowatt hours, it can be a semi-mechanical, a semi-electronic meter, like a Sangamo Schlumberger SPA01 or SPA02. Or it can be a full mechanical meter, like that one up in front of the camera there, or it can be a full electronic one, like one of those ones that I've got in the metering cabinet in the front of the house, okay, where it's just like a little box, a little white box with an LCD display on it. Okay, so the first obvious thing is an electricity meter, and the second thing you're obviously going to need is an energy source. Okay, when I say energy source, I'm not talking about a wall socket with juice in it. I'm talking about one of these. Okay, there they are. Now that there, there's obviously two of them, okay, and they're transformers. And what they do is you, with a variac, is those terminals on the top there. Okay, there they are. Oh, my goodness me. Right, I'm just trying to get this camera right. Those terminals on the top there. Okay, you put the power in there. It goes through the primary. Okay. And then it comes out the secondary at a lesser voltage. okay? But the idea being there is you actually trade off volts or amps, okay? So in that input side, that transformer that you see up in front of the camera there is 110 volts. And the output is 1.3 volts, okay? So instead of having, let's shall we say, 110 volts at, you know, a fraction of an amp, you get 1.3 volts at 30 amps, okay? And that is what drives the electricity meter, okay? And because those 110 volt inputs, I do have two of them, okay? So there's one input there, and there's the other input over there on that one. And I'll wire those in series so that it can be run on, if necessary, the full 240 volts. But if they run okay on full 240 volts and that electricity meter took it, I obviously wouldn't need a variac, which is why in this case I do need a variac, because well, if I just wired those in series and gave it the full 240 volts, they would burn out, the electricity meter would burn out, and so would the cables coming from those going to the electricity meter. So a variac is essential. Yeah, those are the two transformers that Mr. Photon gave me. Okay. And yes, two transformers from Mr. Photon so that I can do phantom loading on electricity meters, okay? Now, to connect those transformers up to our electricity meter, I'm obviously going to need some of these. There they are. Okay, don't worry about that orange plug, I should come into that in a minute. But those there, don't worry about the colours, that's irrelevant. You can see I've crimped some lugs onto the ends of those. And yeah, once again, that was a roll of cable that Mr. Photon donated as well, so that I can get those transformers there connected up to an electricity meter there and make it whack around quite nicely. I do believe that the cross-sectional area of those cables that you see up in front of the camera there are 10mm, and they will quite happily take, I believe, 10mm is 53 amps, or somewhere around about there. As you can see, there's two pairs there, or four cores, and what I should do there is have two of those coming out of transformer, and then the other two with the return power, like that. So I've got two pairs. Okay, so this will come out of transformer 1 and this will come out of transformer 2. Go to the electricity meter. And then this one here will come out and go back to transformer 1. And this one here will come out and go back to transformer 2. Okay. Obviously speaking, the crimp lugged ends go onto those big beefy terminals there. You can see they've got lugs on the ends with bolts on. Okay, and on the other ends of those cables, they're just bare exposed so that I can terminate them off into our electricity meter terminal block. Okay, and then that's where I'll move on to that roll of orange wire. Now that orange wire, that doesn't carry any current, okay? The ends are exposed there. And what that is for is, it's to energize that electricity meter up at its rated voltage. Okay. So there we go. I haven't got my variac in front of this, but you do need a variac in order to do it. Okay. So, yeah. Quick look over the ingredients. Kilowatt hour electricity meter. Energy source, which is going to drive the amps, suitably sized cables, and something to energize the meter up. So for 10 minutes, people, come back and thanks for watching.